We also offer our lotus obeisances again and again at the lotus feet of our entire Murwillumbah, especially the lotus feet of Srila Lord Govinda Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhaktivedanta Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada, and Srila Bhakti Srila Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, and Srila Bhakti Prabhupada Goswami Maharaj. And I offer my pranams tonight at the lotus feet of Puttipad Srila Bhaktivedanta Sridhar Maharaj, dear disciple of our Gurudev, best representative of our Gurudev Siddhanta, and I offer my obeisances to all Vaishnavas, Vaishnavas here present, So, again, we're fortunate. We don't know how long our good fortune will last in this life, but today our Sridhar Maharaj has come to Murwillumbah after long absence. And he's kind of like the rain cloud of good fortune, sharing mercy contained within the ocean of Gopran Ras, and his heart is distributing that Ras and sprinkling drops of Krishna prem in the hearts of all the devotees here. Like the thirsty Chakura birds, they're waiting to hear the Katara Sri Krishna and simply to receive the smiling glance of our Pujipar Sridhar Maharaj. Shastra says Bhaktis tu Bhagavad Sangha Sangina Prajayate Satsanga Kupite Kumbi Purva Sukriti Sanchitai. That to attain the good fortune, the Sukriti, of having Bhagavad Bhakta association is the accumulated merit of your pious activities, Bhakti Unmukh Sukriti, Bhakti pious activities for many, many lifetimes. When that Bhakti Unmukh Sukriti, after many endeavors, comes to fruition, one gets the chance to associate with a first-class Vaishnava who's coming in the Sampradaya, who actually understands his tattva-vid, who understands the conclusions of Vaishnava Sampradaya, Gaudi Vaishnava Sampradaya, and is able to dispel the doubts of the hearers, and is able then to impart the highest bliss, the highest paramanta, which is the highest wealth, which is Krishna prema, by that person's association, because he's fully taken shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, and followed the instructions of a spiritual master to the letter, that person's empowered then to impart Krishna prema to the highest of the devotees. In such a personality like our Sridhar Maharaj, I'm very confident that we're able to achieve that benefit by his grace. And Shastra also says, Na Vaishnavam Vina Bandhu, Na Vaishnavam Vina Guru, Na Vaishnavam Vina Shastram, Na Vaishnavam Vina Gati. It says, no one is a friend. There's no friend in this world other than the Vaishnava. If we think we have friends here and there, then the friends are worthless and meaningless because they'll only assist us on our pathway to hell. But by fully embracing the friendship and the service of the bona fide Vaishnava, we have our greatest affection. No one is a guru other than the pure Vaishnava. And without Vaishnavas, the scriptures do not exist. No one can unlock the understanding of what is the meaning held within the sacred texts which have been transcribed from the words of the sages and compiled by Veda Vyasadeva and his representatives. So without Vaishnava, scripture is inaccessible. And without the Vaishnava, there is no hope for any spiritual attainment. Everything is only, as Swami Maharaj used to say, phantasmal. So we may think we're following spiritual path, but unless we're under the anubhakti, the pure guidance of a bona fide person, hearing from that person, satam prasangam, or the viri sambhido, that rasakatana katara, it can't come in our heart cannot be controlled. It's also said, janmanicha kalamanicha dananicha vamanicha, paravaishnavam satya safalatam priyantihi. So our birth, our activities, our wealth, all our qualities, they certainly become successful by attaining the association of exalted Vaishnava. So we're fortunate and we should hear with great attention because by so doing we'll be able to maximize our good fortune. Srila Gurudev used to tell the story of the devotee called Upamanya. Upamanya had a guru and the guru told him, your service is to go out every day and protect my cows and watch them and take them grazing and keep an eye on them. So he did that, he followed Guru's instruction. But the Guru never told him to take any prasadam, any particular meals. So Guru came to check on him after some days and he said he saw that Upamanya was actually quite well. He was quite fatty and he was doing well. And he said, how are you maintaining yourself? I didn't give you order to take any prasadam. And Upamanya said, I'm just taking a milk. milk from some of the cows every day? I'm taking a little from the milk and the cows are getting the rest. He said, no, I didn't tell you to take milk from the cows either. I'm forbidding you from doing that. You carry on as is. So he took the instruction of his guru seriously and he stopped taking the milk of the cow. And there was no other prasadam for him. He was out in the forest. He had to take grazing with the cows. So eventually he became...
Took the farm from the cow. I know.
We're getting there, okay? Don't keep spoiling the stories. So anyway, Murwillumbah came to see him again. And he saw, hey, you're still seem to be okay. How are you maintaining yourself? He said, well, actually, Gurudev, I'm taking the foam from the mouth of the cows and I'm eating that and I'm nourishing myself on that foam that's coming from the mouth of the cow. He said, hey, Gurudev said, no, I didn't tell you to do that. Don't do that either. Don't maintain yourself like that. Gurudev went back to his ashram. So Ramani was sitting in the forest thinking, okay, he's taking the cows out. Not taking anything, but he started to feel very, very hungry. After 1 day, 2 days, he was very hungry. So I saw these weeds, I forget the name, and Gurudev gave the name of the weed. But the special weed, he started to think they were less some nourishment in there, sort of like dandelion. I'll start eating those weeds, and he started to eat them. But what happened, they were so toxic and so poisonous, he collapsed, he became blind. And he was wandering blind, and he collapsed, he fell into a world, a dark world. And he was sitting there suffering, crying, injured, and with the blindness, he didn't know what happened to him. After some days, Gurudev thought, where's my disciple? There's something wrong, so they went looking for him. The disciples are calling, Ubhumanyu, they're calling everywhere. And from a voice in the world, he heard his guru and said, Gurudev came, and they said, oh, what are you doing there? The disciples pulled him out, and they looked at him. Then the guru said, oh, what happened to you? Gurudev, I was taking this whiz, only by nutrition. That's all.
Sap of the Datura.
Oh, it's Datura. So you're crazy, you take Datura. I knew one sadhu in Nepal, and he was old sadhu, and he had a son. But the son was taking Datura sometime. And he took so much Datura, he became so mad. All he could do all day long, he was sitting in we had a place there where there was some grass, a lawn outside. All day long, he was sitting on the lawn, the son of the sadhu, and he was picking the clover and looking at the clover and eating the clover here for hours, and then after losing his mind to Datura. But Datura is very dangerous, wasn't it? Don't take Datura. So anyway, he took the sap, he became blind. So Gurudev said, why have you done this? He said, Gurudev, you didn't order me to take any prasadam. He told him not to take the milk, not to take the foam of the cows. Now they were so hungry, I took these weeds, and that's what's happened. Gurudev's heart became very soft. He became very, very stricken with compassion for his disciple. And he realized, Gurudev knew that this disciple was fully surrendered to the word of his guru. He was following instruction no matter what, no matter how difficult it became. He was surrendered to the word of his guru, and that was his main qualification. So it says, Tad Viganatam, Sagurum Devabhigachat, Samipanishrotyam Brahmanishtam. That Brahmanishtam, that full strength of complete absorption in the instruction of the guru, is where we carry the firewood upon our head to the sacrificial fire, the spiritual activities performed by the guru. What is that offering we give? It's the false ego. All our wealth, our time, mind, all these things, our words, our body, our energy, whatever we have, we give to the lotus feet of the guru. We understand, I am nothing, everything is yours, and you have to please accept me as your humble disciple. Your Gurudev, I have no other shelter, you are my only shelter. So like this, the devotee gets in the proper mood, and he applies to Gurudev to receive his mercy and his shelter, and then he can progress. The guru is very merciful. He not only wants to deliver us from material existence, cut our cycle of birth and death in this hellish physical world, he also wants to engage us in intimate service of the divine couple and associate with us there as his assistants in the most beautiful and divine, unimaginably sweet environment. He wants to share that premas with us. So we pray to Gurudev that he'll give us the ability to take the best advantage of the short time we have with our Sridhar Maharaj. We pray to Sridhar Maharaj to please be merciful to us. Most of us are very unqualified. Oh, man, myself, I'm very unqualified. Mr. Very unqualified. But we pray that we can survive. Srila Gurudev said once, I read a quote, he said that in India, many devotees are in the mat, they're following, they're chanting, they're doing things that are very, very good. But he said, my special compassion, my special mercy goes to those people in the West. It's very, very hard in the Western countries. They're trying to maintain their Christian consciousness, maintain my mission. So Gurudev said, I'm very, very inclined to those people. So no matter how difficult it gets, we should try and be together, hear Chandra, promote the glories of our guru, and thereby attain their mercy and achieve the goal of life. Thank you.
प्रभु जी ट्रांसफर से कर आप भी बीच बीच में कर लेना, आप भी कभी कर लेना प्रभु जी बीच बीच में दोनों कर हम आए गए। हरे कृष्णा ओम अज्ञान कुमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै स्तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। पांचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतुषे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत श्री राधा कांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुत देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय वृंदाय तुलसीदेवै प्रियाय केशवस्य च कृष्ण भक्ति प्रद देवी सत्यवतै नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद बल हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 बल हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 बल हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्ण। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम अफोर्डिंग माय अनलिमिटेड ओबेइसेंस टू माय स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर नित्यलीला प्रविष्णु विष्णुपाद अष्टोदर सत श्री श्री श्रीमद्भक्ति श्री रूप सिद्धांत गोस्वामी महाराज। आफ्टर सेम ओबेइसेंस टू अफोर्डिंग माय शिक्षा गुरुदेव नित्यलीला प्रविष्णु विष्णुपाद अष्टोदर सत श्री श्री श्रीमद्भक्ति वेदांत श्रील नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज नित्यलीला प्रविष्णु श्रील गौरव गोविंद महाराज एंड ऑल वैष्णव एंड ऑल वैष्णवीज। हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण। माय इंग्लिश इज सो नो सो गुड सो प्रभु इज ट्रांसलेट ओके। हरे कृष्ण आप बोलो दें टुडे यू आर वेरी वेरी फॉर्चुनेट यू आर गैदरिंग हियर लिसनिंग हरि कथा टेलिंग व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कथा। सो कथा कहते कथा का मतलब क्या होता है आप ट्रांसलेट कर कथा का मतलब क्या होता है। क मतलब होता है रस और था मतलब हमें जो जड़ रस से निकाल करके भगवत प्रेम रस में स्थापन कर दे इसलिए इसका नाम होता है कथा।
क मींस द नेक्टर एंड था मींस दैट व्हिच पुल्स अस आउट ऑफ द मटेरियल सिचुएशन दैट वी आर अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन एंड establishes us in the nectar of Harikatha. That is what is Harikatha.
So this is the meaning of the Katha. Are you understand? Yeah, Katha. You know, Srimad Bhagavad, Kat Bhagavad mein Katha ki alag alag baat bataya. Katha ka alag alag uska visheshan diya hai. Isliye Katha ka ek matlab hota hai, Bhagavad mein bataya, kal vyalam mukha grasam. Katha ka udaharan diya hai, कि जो काल है ये काल नहीं एक सर्प है ये जीवों को ये निगलने जा रही है ये काल रूपी सर्प। अगर इससे बचना चाहते हो क्या करनी चाहिए बोले केवल एक उपाय है ये भगवान कथा को केवल श्रवण करें। भगवत कथा से ही ये काल का हाथ से तभी केवल हम बच सकते केवल कथा को द्वारा।
He's saying that there are many definitions of katha in Srimad Bhagavatam. One of the definitions he is describing that how he's saying that kal vyalam
mukha grasa.
He's saying that what it means that this material world, this situation around us, is this kal, is like the death which is approaching us, or like a serpent which is just about to swallow us. But who can save us from being swallowed by this material situation? Only this katha.
इसलिए भारत में एक बढ़िया एग्जाम्पल दिया है. कहते एक नेवला होता है और एक सांप होता है. अब देखना नेवला सांप में लड़ाई होती है. लड़ाई होने पर ये सांप कोशिश करता है नेवला को काटने के लिए. लेकिन जब नेवला काटता है, ये नेवला को एक दबा होता है. वो क्या करता है, झट चले जाता है जंगल में और जा करके हैं कहते एक्सक्यूज मी, काल को कहता है सांप एक्सक्यूज मी मैं आ रहा हूँ. इसलिए जाकर झट उसको जड़ी बूटी बता रहे उसको खा लेता है. खा कर फिर लड़ाई करता है. अगर फिर सांप काटता है ना, फिर वो कहता है एक्सक्यूज मी मैं अभी आता हूँ. फिर जाता है, फिर जाकर दबाव करता है. तब फिर लड़ते 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 अंतिम में वो सांप को मार देता है. इसलिए इसका शिक्षा देते हैं कि कहते उसी तरह ये काल का जो प्याल है सर्प है, लेकिन अगर इससे बचना चाहते हैं उपाय क्या, केवल भगवत कथा है. जो भगवत कथा को नेवला नहीं, जो दवा है भगवान की कथा. जो भगवान की कथा रूप अमृत को पान करे केवल वही केवल ये काल रूपी सर्प से बच सकती है.
He is describing that there is an example we hear that how there is, we know that always the mongoose and the snake, they are always enmity towards each other. They are always fighting each other. When they will see each other, they have to attack each other. But sometimes what happens is, usually the mongoose comes out victorious, but sometimes he also gets bitten by the snake. The moment he gets bitten by the snake, then it poison is going to take effect. So the mongoose says to the snake, or consider the snake to be the calf, then he says, excuse me, I'm coming now. And he goes away. He knows, the mongoose knows, there are some herbs in the forest, and it goes and chews on this these herbs, and then becomes healthy again. It comes back free from the effect of the poison, and comes back and starts fighting with the serpent again. And it comes back again, and again maybe it is bitten by the serpent again. Again by the kal it is bitten again, and then again it goes, excuse me, I'm coming. Again it goes away, relieves itself from the fighting, and then again goes in the forest and eats this herb. And again it comes back. So this mongoose knows, and it keeps on, how many times it will be bitten by the serpent, it will keep on going to the forest and keep on eating this herb till it defeats the snake. So it's saying that this mongoose is us, this snake is the kal, and it is always trying to swallow us. And this herb that the mongoose is finding in the forest, this is Harikatha. We will never be able to find any other way to free ourselves from this material situation that we have fallen in, or this kal which is ready to swallow us every time. And this, which is, what is this nectar, what is this herb which is making us free from the poisonous effects of the kal? It is this Harikatha.
So, Sutta Goswami, you know, Srimad Bhagavat telling, like, Ayur Harati Vai Punsan Uddhan Astancha Janaso Tasarite Jam Khanam Nita Uttama Slokavartha. So, Sutta Goswami get a nice example. Kati jo suraj nahi ye kaal hai. Kati ye purva disha mein uday ho karke paschima disha mein jab asta ho gaye, wo hamare ek din nasht kar diya hai. एक दिन वो नष्ट कर दिया है. कभी ये सूरज नहीं, ये काल है. लेकिन ये सभी का समय को तो सूरज नष्ट करता है, लेकिन सुत गोस्वामी कहते किसका समय को नष्ट नहीं कर पाता है. बोले तस्सरिते जम क्षण लेकर, जितने समय उनकी कथा में भजन और भक्ति में लगाते हैं केवल उतना समय को ही ये काल नष्ट नहीं कर पाता है, लेकिन सब काल को नष्ट कर देता है. इसलिए वृंदावन दास ठाकुर कहते हैं सभी के काल को डरते हैं. मरने के लिए कौन नहीं डरता है, लेकिन सब तो काल को डरता है. लेकिन काल एक व्यक्ति को डरता है, बोले किसको, बोले भगवान के भजन को, भगवान की भक्ति को. भक्तों को डरता है, क्यों, भक्त हर समय भगवान की भजन करते हैं. इसलिए प्रभु का जो हरिनाम कथा जो सुनते हैं वो काल से अतीत है. इसलिए कभी सूरज काल ही है, सबका समय नष्ट कर रहा है, लेकिन हरि कथा सुनने वाले को व्यक्ति का नष्ट नहीं कर पाता.
So he's describing that how Sita Goswami is reporting a shloka. The translation of the shloka is, he's saying that this sun, it rises every day in the east and sets in the west every day. And this actually, Sita Goswami is saying, this is not sun, it is the kal itself. Because when it gets up, rises in the east, sets in the west, what it has done, every day you're losing one day of your life gradually, day by day you are losing. But he's also saying further, whom it does not, is not able to take away the life of, he's saying those people who are absorbed in the bhajan, the time that they spend every day in bhajan, understand that that time is not lost. That there are
Everybody afraid to death.
Yeah, everybody is afraid to death. But who is he are not afraid of? Or rather, Kaal itself, Kaal serpent itself, the death itself is afraid of somebody who? That is person who is absorbed in Harikatha. That person who is absorbed in devotional activities. So he is afraid of such a person.
Yeah, he is afraid to only devotee. No, everybody afraid to death. But death only afraid to devotee. Why? Always devotee they are chanting, remembering, thinking. And always they are doing bhajan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. इसलिए कथ भागवत में ये जो कथा को अलग-अलग नाम दिया है. कथा को एक नाम दिया आसव मतलब शराब मदिरा है उसका एक उदाहरण थे मदिरा है कहते जो साधारण जो मदिरा उसको जो पान करते हैं उसका नशा धीरे 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 उतर आती है लेकिन जो भक्ति की जो नशा है ना वो कभी उतरती नहीं वो नशा चढ़ती रहती है ये नशा चढ़ती रहती है कभी उतरती नहीं इसलिए उसको उदाहरण दिया आसव एक सुंदर उदाहरण दिए अगर बेटा अगर शराब पीता है पिता अगर शराब पीता है वो कभी भी अपना बेटे को बोलेगा नहीं तो शराब पी वो बोलेगा बेटा कम से कम तू बच करके रहा मैं अपना जीवन को मैंने बर्बाद कर दिया शराब पी करके लेकिन तू कभी शराब भूल से मत दिया कर लेकिन ये कथा भी जो शराब है अगर ये पिता अगर पी लेगा ना बेटे को बोले भैया तू भी एक बार पी कर दे इसमें कितने रस है इसमें कितने आनंद तू तो एक बार पी करके बकेट से पैसा निकाल करके खुद पिलाने के लिए कोशिश करेगा मतलब क्या जैसे आप लोग भक्तों को बुलाते हो कितने पैसा खर्चा करते हो कितना कष्ट करके पैसा कमाते और पैसा वो कितने कष्ट से कमाते लेकिन वो पैसा वो कैसे खर्च कर रहे हो कोई इंडिया से भक्त आएगा हाँ उसमें फेस्टिवल होगा हम पैसा पैसा अपना पकेट से खर्चा करके सारा दुनिया को बुला बुला कर पिलाते हैं भैया तू एक बार पी करके देख उसमें कितने आनंद है इसीलिए एक करके इसको एक आसव बताया कि ये शराब है लेकिन ये नशा इतने चढ़ती है वो कभी घटती नहीं वो चढ़ती रहती है नशा है
He's just showing there are many definitions of Katha in Srimad Bhagavatam. One of the definitions is to describe this as asav. Asav means wine or an intoxicating alcoholic beverage. He's saying if somebody is drinking alcohol in this world, we see that he drinks and he's maybe very drunk for a few hours. After that few hours, he gets back to normal. And then again, to remain high on alcohol, the effect of alcohol, he again has to drink alcohol after a few hours or something. But this is such, Harikatha is such an intoxicating beverage that a person drinks and he never gets drunk from this high. And if we have seen in this world, suppose there is some father who is drinking alcohol, he will never tell his son to drink alcohol. He will tell, you stay away from this alcohol because he knows the bad effect of the alcohol. He said that I have spoiled my entire life drinking this alcohol. You please at least stay away from this alcohol. But this intoxicating beverage of Harikatha is such that whoever drinks, he wants the other person also to drink. The father has drunk it and he's always insisting on his son, you try at least once to listen to this Harikatha, you at least drink this nectar once. And suppose the wife has taken this, had the opportunity of drinking this beverage, this intoxicating beverage of Harikatha, then she says to the husband, oh, you come and listen to this, at least once come and why? Because this is so beautiful and so nectarian that everybody wants that whoever has tasted this nectar, whoever has tasted this intoxicating beverage of Harikatha, they want others also to drink. And it is such that, it is such nectar that you will, suppose somebody is saying that, no, I don't want to listen to Harikatha, then what do? You spend your own money so that this person will be able to drink this beverage. How you spend your money? You take out your money from your pocket and then you call devotees from India, how we will have facility, how we will have a beautiful festival and we will arrange nice Harikatha and we will invite so many people to arrange festivals so that people will come and drink this Harikatha. So this is such an intoxicating beverage that alcohol's effect, it lessens by the hour. But this Harikatha is such that it increases by the hour, by the day.
इसलिए कथ भागवत में कथा को और एक एग्जाम्पल दिया है कहते उसमें एक एग्जाम्पल दिया है कहते ये क्या है भगवान की कथा है कहते भगवान जो कथा है रसमालयम कहते ना रसमालयम इसलिए श्री सुतो श्री कपिल देव अपना माँ को कहते हैं satang prasangat mam virja sambidau bhavate hrititan rasayana. इसलिए भगवान कपिलदेव अपना माँ को कहते हैं, बोले माँ ये कथा नहीं, ये रसायन है। कहती रसायन एक मेडिसिन है, वो 10 तरह का आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन से बनता है, और जिस रसायन को पान करने पर कहते शरीर का सारे बीमारी सही हो जाती है, और शरीर में बड़ी ताकत आ जाती है अगर उसको दवा को अगर कोई ग्रहण करे, वो रसायन है। कहते भगवान कहते, बोले माँ ये कथा नहीं, ये रसायन है, जिसको कोई पान करेगा ना भास, कहते भव औषध छत्र, कहते जितने तुम्हारी बीमारी शरीर का है वो सारी बीमारी तुम्हारी खत्म हो जाएगी अगर कोई भगवान की कथा कर सुनेगा तो। इसलिए बोले हृत कर्ण, वो किसको रस प्रदान करते हैं, बोले हृदय और कान को, ये दोनों का रस प्रदान करते हैं। इसलिए कोई संत कह रहे थे इसको पियो ना, बड़े हार्ट अटैक तुम्हारी नहीं होगी। हार्ट अटैक कब होता है, जब ज्यादा लीवर से चले जाते ना, हार्ट अटैक कब होता है। लेकिन जो भगवान की भक्ति करते हैं कोई चिंता है, वो तो भगवान की भजन में मस्त रहते हैं भगवान की भक्ति में। इसलिए कहते हैं इसको हार्ट अटैक नहीं होगा, बोले हृदय और जो कर्ण है कान, ये दोनों को रस प्रदान करना। इसलिए श्री रूप गोस्वामी कहते हैं, बोले तुंडे तान विकल उठे तुंडा बलिलब्धये कर्णा क्रणो कडमिनि घटयते कर्णा बुधेव स्वीया चेत प्रांगण संगिनि रचयते सर्वे इन्द्रियाणां कृते न जाने जनित किम अद्भुत कृष्णेति वर्णत। इसलिए रूप गोस्वामी कहते हैं, कहते भगवान को तो सृष्टि, ब्रह्मा जी को तो सृष्टि करना आता ही नहीं, अरे इतने कृष्ण उदय होता है, ऐसे जब तांडव नृत्य करना शुरू करता है, हैं बोले जीवा को अर्पित अर्पित जीवा की प्रार्थना करता है, लेकिन हृदय में जो बरसती है लगता है जो प्रेम रसधारा बरस रही है। इसलिए कहते हृदय और कान को, ये दोनों को रस प्रदान करने वाले कौन है, कहते भगवान कथा। इसलिए भगवान कपिल देव कहते माँ ये कथा नहीं, ये रसायन है।
So another definition which Murwillumbah is saying that Kapildev is saying to his mother, he's saying Satang Prasangma Mam Virya Sambhito Bhavanti Hit Karne Rasayan Pratha. He's saying that this is Rasayan. He's saying this is Rasayan. Rasayan means a tonic. Usually a Rasayan word is used for a tonic which is made of 10 herbs in Ayurveda, known as a Rasayan, made up of 10 herbs. And when you drink this tonic, it gives you strength in all the body. You become strong and you nothing will disturb you, no disease, nothing. And he's saying similarly, this is also a tonic. And it is giving, this tonic is giving strength to, it is giving to hrit karna, means it is giving strength to the heart and to the ears. He's saying, and Rupa Goswami is describing, he's saying that
some devotees are telling, if you drink this harikatha, you are never happening your heart attack. Why? When somebody making heart attack, when we are becoming so much depression, but we are doing bhajan, they are always happy, no? They are always happy life. So why making heart attack? No? So they are never making any heart attack.
So this tonic is like this, that you will never have heart attack, you will never suffer from any disease, because the disease or the heart attack comes from depression. And we will never, a person who is hearing this or drinking this nectar of harikatha, he is never depressed. And similarly, Sri Rupa Goswami Pada is also describing that he is saying that, the Brahmaji doesn't know how to create. He has created this human body, but he doesn't know how to create. He doesn't understand that there is so much nectar in these two syllables, Krishna. There is so much nectar that when it is dancing on the cheeks, it is like I desire millions and millions of times. And when it is entering through the ears, then I feel like that I should have, why only 2 years? I should have millions, millions of ears. And then it enters through the ears, from the tongue it enters to the heart, and it feels like that there is a shower of nectar on the person who is hearing this. So this is the strength of the Harikatha, that a person never feels any depression and always remains strong.
Yes. So, Prithu Maharaj, when Kaji Samay Se Prithu Maharaj Go, Bhagavan Kate Barmago. हमसे कुछ क्या चाहते हो, तो पृथ्वी महाराज कहते प्रभु मेरे को 10,000 कान दे। बोले 10,000 का दो कान तो बढ़िया लग रहा है, अगर यहाँ दो कान हो जाए, यहाँ दो कान, अगर सारा शरीर में कान ही कान हो जाए थोड़ी अच्छी लगेगी। बोले प्रभु
हम सारा शरीर में कान नहीं चाहते, कान तो दो ही हो, लेकिन दोनों कानों में कथा सुनने की इतने शक्ति दे दो जैसे 10,000 कानों से शक्ति सुनने का, इतनी। ये एक अर्थ है, विश्वनाथ चतुर्थ टीका में कहते हैं कि दूसरा अर्थ है जैसे कथा यहाँ हो रही, कथा और भी तो नहीं हो, कहते जितने स्थान पर कथा होती है मैं चाहता हूँ कहीं की कथा चुप नहीं आए, जितने जगह पर कथा हर जगह पर में उतना स्वरूप को लेकर के तुम्हारी कथा में सुनकर हूँ। इसलिए यहाँ पर कहते हैं श्री पृथ्वी महाराज कहते हैं, कहते प्रभु मेरे को दो हाथ से क्या हो रहा, दो हाथ से सेवा करके मेरे को आनंद नहीं आ रहा, मेरे को 10,000 हाथ दे दो, मतलब सारे सेवा तुम्हारे नहीं करो और किसी को सेवा करने के लिए नहीं दो, सारे सेवा ही नहीं करो, क्योंकि भगवान के भजन में भगवत भक्ति में इतने आनंद इतने रस है।
Another description of Prithu Maharaj. Prithu Maharaj is being asked by the Lord that what do you desire? Prithu Maharaj says that I want 10,000 ears. And the Lord replies that Shri Thakur is describing that what is the meaning of this asking 10,000 ears? He's in his commentary to the stroke, he's describing that 10,000 ears, the Lord says that 10,000 ears, 2 years on a face looks beautiful. A person looks presentable. But suppose there are 10,000 ears, means there will not be space enough on the body. It will have to go on the head, on the face, on the shoulders, on the legs, on the arms, everywhere. He said, how will this body look? He said, Prithu Maharaj is saying, oh Lord, what I mean by 10,000 ears is, then give me the strength of 10,000 ears through these 2 years, that I will absorb this Harikatha as one would be able to absorb Harikatha by 10,000 ears. This is one meaning. Another meaning is described that, now we are speaking Harikatha here, but certainly this is not the only spot where the Harikatha is being spoken right now. There must be so many other places where Harikatha is being spoken. He's saying the meaning of asking 10,000 years is that, oh Lord, wherever the Harikatha is being spoken, I want to be able to absorb, to be able to hear Harikatha from all the places. And then Prithu Maharaj further says that I don't want two hands. I don't want just two hands. I want 10,000 hands. Why? He's saying that there is so much bliss, so much nectar in serving the Lord, performing devotional activities. He's saying, but this is not sufficient. These 2 hands are not sufficient. I want 10,000 hands. If I have 10,000 hands, then I will not give a chance for anybody else. I will not ask help from anybody. I will not ask anybody's support. I will do all your seva, O my Lord, with my own 10,000 hands.
So, इसलिए कैसे भगवान कपिल देव कहते हैं जो भगवत जो कथा है इतने शक्तिशाली प्रभु का कथा ब्लसतांग प्रसंगात्मक बीज संबित हो तो कहते हैं पर कथा सुननी कहाँ चाहिए, बोले जहाँ तक कथा नहीं सुननी चाहिए, मना किया है, बोले केवल साधु से ही कथा सुननी चाहिए और कहीं से नहीं है, और कहीं से नहीं। इसलिए सिर्फ पद्म पुराण में बताया ना, जैसे दूध होता है, कैसे दूध होता है पीने से पुष्टि तुष्टि हितकार के, लेकिन उसी दूध में जब सांप मुंह मार देता है वो देखने के लिए तो लगता है दूध है, लेकिन उसको पियो तो पूरा मृत्यु का कारण बनता है। इसलिए विश्वनाथ चतुर्थ ठाकुर कहते हैं जो कान भी जो दौड़ा है ना सबको मत दिया करो, वो कहते हैं बोले किसको, तो बोले जिसको संबंध ज्ञान नहीं है उसको मत दिया करो। जैसे भारत में बहुत सारे कथाकार थे, कहते इसी देवा को पूजा करो, उसी देवी को पूजा करो, उसको पूजा करो, सारा दुनिया की पूजा की बात करता है। जिसका बुद्धि स्वयं भ्रमित है, अगर उससे अगर हम कथा सुनेंगे तो हम स्वयं बुद्धि भ्रमित हो जाए। इसलिए विश्वनाथ चतुर्थ ठाकुर कहते भैया कान भी दुना जिसको जिसको मैं दिया करो, देखो कथा कहाँ से सुन रहे हो, वो व्यक्ति करता है क्या, क्योंकि जो स्वयं भ्रमित है अगर उसको कथा कान दे दो तो तुम स्वयं भ्रमित हो जाओगे। इसलिए कहते जिसको संबंध ज्ञान पता नहीं, हम किसी को भक्ति करनी चाहिए वहाँ कथा मत सुनो। इसलिए कहते सता कथा जहाँ तहाँ नहीं साधु से ही कथा सुननी चाहिए। सत्ता कैसे बोले प्रसंगा, यहाँ पर जो एक एक शब्द प्रयोग करते हैं बड़े महत्वपूर्ण शब्द प्रयोग करते हैं, कहते प्रसंगा संग ही प्रसंग, प्रसंग मतलब कहते साधु का जो जटा जटा होता है उसमें भी जो भी वास करता है लेकिन वो खून चूसता है, मच्छर भी जाकर उसको खून चूसता है मच्छर जैसे नहीं, जीव जैसे संग नहीं। कहते प्रसंग मतलब होता है उसका उपदेश को वास्तव रूप में उसका उपदेश को पालन करनी चाहिए, केवल बैठे सुने बस तुम जाओ अपना जाओ अपना ऐसे नहीं। इसलिए कहते प्रसंगा मतलब पूर्ण रूप में उनके संग कर उनका उपदेश को और भजन आदर्श को जीवन में ग्रहण करनी चाहिए।
So Kapildev is speaking to his mother. He's describing in this shloka, Sapang Prasang Mam Vira Samvido. He's saying Sapang, Sapang, what it means. He's saying this Harikatha, whom we should hear this Harikatha from. He's saying we should not hear Harikatha. It's not that we can go and hear Harikatha. Wherever somebody is speaking Harikatha, we'll go and start listening Harikatha. Somebody who doesn't have proper Sambandha Gyan, we should not listen Harikatha from such a person. Somebody, we will go in India, we will see so many people, they are speaking Harikatha. They are saying that they are speaking Harikatha. What are they saying? They are saying if you listen to them, they will say that, oh, you can worship Ganesh, you can worship Shiva, you can worship Shankar, you can worship this, you can worship anybody. They have opened like a marketplace for all the demigods that you come and I will give you mantra and you can, whatever you desire, you can worship. This is not proper. He said, this Vishwanathaki Thakur is describing that this cup of your ears, you should not give to everybody. This cup of ears you should protect and you should give to only that person who has proper Sambandha Gyan. And then there is also a description in Tarun Pran. Yes, Harikatha is very nectarian, Harikatha is very powerful and it can give us so much, it can even change our heart, change our life. But same Harikatha, just like he's giving Tarun Pran, there is an example of milk, that the milk is like a tonic. Like a nectar, it gives strength, it gives so much benefit for the material body. But the same milk, if it is touched by the mouth of a serpent, if you drink that milk, it can be the cause of your death. Similarly, be careful. Be careful in saying that you do not listen to Harikatha from everybody. Anybody who doesn't have proper Sambandha Gyan, you should not listen to him. And then, Satang Prasangam. Prasangam means what? Prasang, Prasang.
You know, Satang Gurudev, Gurudev gave a pretty nice example, you know, our Gurudev Bhaktivedanta Narayana Prasangam. He gave very nice example he gave. Kata bhakti ko ek lata bataya. Bhakti ko ek lata bataya. Lekin agar lata nahi, agar wahan par khari pani de doge, samudra ka pani kya hoga? Woh to pehle mar jayegi. Woh pehle mar jayegi, jinda nahi rahegi. Lekin agar usme meetha pani doge, meetha pani doge, phir to woh lata badhiya badhegi. Ab Gurudev aur ek udaharan dete hain, jaise pani usme thodi si chini dal diya, thodi gulab jal dal diya. फिर केसर डाल दिया, फिर क्या होगा? वो और भी मीठा होगा, वो भी और मीठा होगा। इसलिए गुरुदेव कहते हैं, ये संघ की प्रभाव से ना, ये भक्ति धीरे-धीरे आगे बढ़ती है। इसलिए गुरुदेव एग्जांपल देते हैं, अगर रसी की भक्तों का संघ अगर किया, तो रसी की भक्तों का अगर संघ किया, जो कि ब्रज रस रसी, अगर ऐसे भक्तों का संघ अगर ऐसे पाइंट हो गए, लता क्या होगी? फिर वहां से जो निकलेगा फिर वो ब्रज रस भक्ति जुट जाएगी। महाप्रभु की भक्ति रस में जाएगी। और इसलिए कृष्णदास के विराज गोस्वामी कहते हैं जाओ भागवत अर्पण वैष्णव स्थाने एकांत आश्रय कर चैतन्य चरण। इसलिए कहते कौन सा भक्तों का संग करनी चाहिए? मतलब महाप्रभु
चैतन्य
गुरुदेव, यू नो, हरिदेव के रूप शिक्षा महा गुरुदेव के क्लास, देन गुरुदेव कमेंट्री, गुरुदेव ही गेव दिस कमेंट्री।
He's saying prasang. Prasang means we have to take a very specific association, like how, that not just that we will go and we will, after hearing Harikatha, we will come back and absorb in our daily activities whatever we used to know. Whatever Harikatha we have learned, whatever Harikatha we have heard from the sadhu, we come back and we absorb that in our life. We try to adopt those teachings in our life. That is proper sang. And he's saying otherwise there are so many mosquitoes also who take some of the Vaishnavas, who just drink the blood from the skin of the Vaishnava. So there are maybe some lice on the hair of a Vaishnava. They also drink the blood. They are taking association. If you just hear Harikatha and wash your hands off Harikatha and come back and again absorb in the same activities, it is like the taking association of such a like a lice or a mosquito. He's saying then Gurudev used to give example that how to associate, what kind of association we should take. He's describing that how Gurudev used to say that suppose there is a creeper, you have planted you have put a plant or a creeper in your garden. Now if you water it,
this is the bhakti, so Vishwanath Chakravarti said, this is the bhakti or kind of creeper, this is bhakti.
Bhakti is like compared to a creeper, he said, and this creeper, suppose there is a creeper and now you water it, the water of the ocean, which is salty, what will happen? Will it flourish? No, it will die. But you...
Gurudev tell you, what is the... Water was ever. Many if you do the association of Jnani, Karmi, Yogi, this is the water of was ever. Then what happened? Your Bhakti Lata never going to breath. Then by Bhakti Lata, Jnana Marga, Karma Marga, Yoga Marga. Then your Bhakti Lata complete test. Okay? Then the rest rest. So, Gurudev tells me, be careful of this thing. You know? When doing some association, then be careful of this thing.
And then he's saying, but if you water it now, sweet water, if you water it, proper water, if you water this creeper, it will flourish. Now this water also can be made further sweet. How? If you add a little lemon, you add a little camphor, you add a little saffron, now it becomes even more sweet. So what it means, he's saying, Sri Krishna's Bhagavad Gita Swami is describing, that if you take the association, and after this association,
So Krishna Sakuraj Goswami telling Jaha Bhagavata Para Vaisnava Sthani. If you are listening Hari Katha, you can go to Vaisnava Sthani. Which kind of Vaisnava Sthani? Chaitanya Bhattar Tuhi Nitya Krasanga. Necessary, if this is the only Krishna, this is the Krishna Bhakta. If you only listening Hari Katha, then what happening? Then you are both going to Krishna Bhakti. Yes. But Gurudev tells you, if you associate of Mahaprabhu Devati, then what happening? So Bhakti Vinod Thakur telling, when you have Siddhi, then you can cut both places. You know, same time you can go to Goloka Vrindavan and same time you go to Mahaprabhu Vrindavan. Like this Gurudev telling that Rupa Goswami, he is the Mahaprabhu pastime in the Rupa Goswami. But Rupa Manjari is the Krishna's pastime in the Rupa Manjari. Sanatana Goswami, Mahaprabhu pastime in the Sanatana Goswami. Krishna pastime is the Lavana Manjari. Sarupadamadar, Mahaprabhu pastime, the Sarupadamadar, Krishna pastime is the Lalita Sati. Yeah. Ramananda is the Mahaprabhu pastime, the Raya Ramananda, and Krishna pastime is the Visaya Sati. So, Gurudev, he told, so if you are doing associate for Mahaprabhu devotee, then you can understand complete to Srimad Bhagavad. One day you can completely observe this Krishna Bhakti Ras. You know, Krishna Bhakti Ras, then you can learn. So Satam Prasanga. Bale Mama Birja Sambido. Kate Bhagavani Kathake is a Kudanya Birja. Birja Sambido, Okatha Sadhana Kathani, Obra Palavar Kathai, Obri Balavar Kathai, Sri, G. Goswami's Kudan the Tani, Kate Prashnehi, Priham Kathak Jahata Kuni Sunni. Kabhi Vaishnava se, hi katha kyun sunte hain? Jaise Harinam hai, phir hum Guru ji se Vaishnava se kyun Guru Harinam liye? Mantra hum Vaishnava se kyun liye? Puran Shastra mein likha hua hai. Shastra mein likha hua hai, wahan se padh lo. Bole nahi, wo kaam nahi karega. Isliye Jiv Goswami kehte hain, jaise aise kuch vriksha hota hai, jise vriksha ka beej direct lekar ke bo to nahi hoga. Wo peepal ped aur bargat ka ped. Uska vidhan kya hai? Koi chidiya khata hai. चिड़िया खाने का बाद फिर उसको पेट में जाता है, उसको पेट में एक तरह का रस वो बीज को शक्ति प्रदान करता है, वो बीज को फिर जब वो बीट करता है फिर जाकर वो वृक्ष होता है, वो डायरेक्टली गेट तो वृक्ष वहाँ नहीं होगी, वो वृक्ष होगी नहीं, इसलिए उसका नियम करते उसी तरह कहते कथा मम बीज संभी तो बलवान कथा का होगा जब किसी साधु के मुँह से हरी कथा निकलेगी क्यों मतलब उनके हृदय में भगवान के प्रति जो प्रेम जो भाव है वो भाव बस साथ में वो कथा निकलती है इसलिए उसमें शक्तिवान कथा होती है हैं उसमें शक्तिवान कथा होती नहीं तो वो कथा शक्तिवान नहीं देगा तो फल नहीं देगा कथा इसलिए कथा सुननी चाहिए इससे बोले शुद्ध वैष्णव से कथा सुननी चाहिए
तो सदा प्रसंग मंगीर संविदो मीन्स दिस सरिकत ऑफ माइंड इज वेरी पावरफुल इट इज इफ इट इज वेरी पावरफुल समबडी विद क्वेश्चन if the Harinam and Harikatha they are so powerful, then we can read the books on our own, the scriptures on our own. And why do we have to go to a guru? And why do we have to take mantra from a guru? We can read this mantra that is written all over the books. We can read the mantra and we can take this mantra. He says, no, this is not the process. The process of this is that, just like Yoga Goswami is giving an example, that there are some trees, like peepal or a banyan tree. These are such trees that if the seeds, you will see that the people or a banyan tree, under the people or a banyan tree, never there will grow a banyan or a people tree. It will grow somewhere very, maybe on the rooftop of a house and all. Why? Because a bird eats this seed. If you try to put this seed directly in the ground, it will never fructify. It is not able to fructify because it is not potent enough. So when did it get potent? He's saying, Mam Virya Samvido. Yes, it is strong. But when did it become this potent? When did it get this potency? Krishna resides in the heart of the Vaishnava and when he speaks this Harikatha, this bhav, this emotions, this mood of his affection and love towards Krishna, they are imbibed in this Harikatha. And when you hear this Harikatha, then this is powerful. Similarly, this bird takes this seed and it swallows it, and there is digestive juice in its belly, and because of this digestive juice, now it can fructify. So when this bird will go and pass through on even the rooftops and all, it will grow there. So similarly, this Harikatha, although it is very powerful, but it will only show its potency when heard from a Vaishnava who is having love affection and attachment towards the divine couple and towards the Harikatha.
कहते एक वृक्ष होने के लिए तीन चीज की जरूरत है, कहते मिट्टी चाहिए, एक हवा, पानी, ये तीन चीज होगा ना तभी कोई वृक्ष बने, तो वृक्ष नहीं होगा। लेकिन आप देखिएगा जब ये चिड़िया कहीं पायखाना करता है छत्र पर, आप देखना वहाँ पर कोई मिट्टी मिट्टी कुछ है नहीं, वो सीमेंट सीमेंट है, है? वो सीमेंट है, देखना वहाँ पर वृक्ष हो जाता है। आप देखना पेड़ का उसको उखाड़ दो, फिर दोबारा वहां पर पेड़ हो जाता है, और इतनी जोर जबरदस्ती पेड़ होता है वो छत को फाड़ देता है, लास्ट में छत को फाड़ देता है। हाँ, इसका मतलब क्या, इसका मतलब है कहते भक्ति कब होता है, कहते सुकृति पूर्व संचित है, कहते पूर्व पूर्व जन्म का सुकृति से भगवान की भक्ति मिलती है। लेकिन भक्तों का संग इतने बलवान बताया, इतने बलवान भक्तों का संग, श्रेष्ठ भक्तों का संग इतने बलवान है, कहते तुम्हारे हृदय में कोई भक्ति की कोई चांस नहीं है। बोले श्री राधा गोविंद बिहारी जी की जय। कहते भक्ति की कोई चांस नहीं, यहाँ पर वहां पर भी भक्ति प्रकट कर देते हैं। इसलिए श्री राय रामानंद महापुरुष संवाद में, राय रामानंद संवाद में तो उन्होंने बताया, कृष्ण भक्ति रस भाविता मती क्रियता कुतम यदि लभ्यते तत्र लौलमृल्लमितलम कोटि सुकृति अपि न लभ्यते। मतलब भक्तों का संग की इतने महत्व श्री राय रामानंद देते हैं, अगर कहीं तुम्हें कृष्ण भक्ति रस में जो संपूर्ण सरावर हो गए, जो भक्त हैं, अगर ऐसे भक्त का संग अगर मिल जाए ना, भक्ति का होता है सुकृत पूर्व संचित है, पूर्व पूर्व का सुकृति का अनुरूप भक्ति, लेकिन भक्तों का संग इतने महान है, बोले करोड़ों भक्तों का संग, कहते सुकृत से जो वस्तु प्राप्त नहीं होता है, भगवत शुद्ध भक्त का संघर्ष भक्ति का प्रकट हो जाता है, वो उदय कर देते हैं। बगर कुछ नहीं तुम्हारे हृदय में नारद का संग हो गया, ब्याज से जो जानवर को आधा मार कर रखते तड़पड़ तड़पड़ करता था, लेकिन जो नारद का संग हुआ, बस संघर्ष ही उसकी संघर्ष ही इतने बड़े भक्त हो गए, इतने बड़े भक्त। वाल्मीकि जैसे देखो, जो ब्राह्मण की जन्म उसे कुआ कर दिया, लेकिन नारद जी के संग हो गया, कल राम बोलो उसका मुंह से राम नहीं निकला, बोले मरा मरा बोलो हम मरा मरा तो कर सकता। इसलिए उल्टा नाम जब तक जग जाना वाल्मीकि भय ब्रह्म समाना, इतने बड़े राम आने से पहले रामायण लिखे थे। इसलिए भक्त संघ की सबसे ज्यादा जो महत्व है, ये भक्तों का संघ का सबसे ज्यादा महत्व है।
So he is elaborating this, that how this bird swallows the seed and then that passes through on the maybe rooftop or some very sandy place at all, and there also this tree will fructify. Now he's describing that, what does it mean? He's saying that usually when you plant a tree, when you plant a seed, then three things are needed: the soil, the water, and the air and sun. These things are needed for the seed to fructify. But now there is no soil on the rooftop; it is just cement, it's just bricks. But it has now, because it has been digested, it has been given this potency by the digestive juices of the bird, that even this seed gets on the rooftop, it can grow there. And it grows there, you pluck it out. You pluck it out and you will see after a few minutes, after a few days, few weeks, again it has grown up. And what it does in the end, it will just break the entire roof. So what does it mean, Srila, in the dialogues between, the conversation between Srila Raya Ramanan and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Raya Ramanan is describing that it is so powerful, the association of a devotee, of a Vaishnava, it is so powerful that when do you get bhakti? Bhakti you get only when you have sukriti from millions and millions of lives. But now, look at this, similarly, understand that this rooftop, absolutely there is no chance, there is no situation for a seed to fructify, but here also it will fructify. Similarly, if you get the association of a devotee, bhakti usually, he is saying that, you get by the sukriti. But what he says, Raya Raman is saying, he's saying that what you will not get by millions of lives of sukriti, you can but get by the expression of a devotee. Like the example of Narad Muni. The example of Narad Muni, when he meets the hunter. He meets the hunter, and what is this hunter? He is killing the animals, he is half killing them, not even killing them full, he is torturing them. And he has no proper qualification, but just by expression of Narayana, and he described Valmiki. Who is Valmiki? Valmiki is going to describe that he used to kill Brahmins. He used to kill, he killed so many Brahmins that all the Brahmins that he killed, he would collect their sacred thread and he used to put them in the well. And the well had become completely full by the sacred thread of the all the Brahmins that he had killed. But still, because of the aspiration of a devotee, what happened? He's, although he's asked to chant the name of Ram, he said, I can't even chant the name of Ram. And then he said that, oh, you chant the name Mara. So he, by chanting Mara, Mara means somebody in death. So he's chanting just by chanting Mara, 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 gradually starts to chant Ram. And then he becomes like Brahm, means he wrote the Ramayana many, many, many years before Lord Ram incarnated. So this is the power of the association of a devotee.
So Lisatang Prasangar, Mama Birja Sandido, Kani Mamar or in Badya Vidhanya. Kat Mama Birja, Kathakwe Birja Vasat Mudharanya, well a king. So I think we basically back up every day. Well a lady come and kapta chanchalati. Kapta egg lady come and chanchalati will jump with pet me bachaniya. Like jab usko pet mein bachcha aa jati hai na, phir uska chanchalata kam ho jati hai. Phir wo nazar deti hai, wo bachche ko kaise paale, bachche ko kaise lalan paalne, bachche ko kaise bada hona hai, bachche ko kaise kya kare, hain? Lekin usko pehle kya hota hai? Usko pehle uska main idhar udhar idhar udhar idhar udhar bhagti rehti hai. Isliye yahan par kehte hain Bhagwan ki jo katha hai ye mama birja. Ye santo ka sangha jab tak nahi karenge, tab tak hamara man na kabhi idhar jayenge, kabhi udhar bhagenge, kabhi udhar bhagenge, kabhi udhar bhagte rahenge. लेकिन जो वैष्णव का संग हम ले आते हैं फिर हमें पता चलता है भगवान कौन है, जीव कौन है, माया कौन है, भक्ति कौन है, प्रेम कौन है, गुरुदेव कौन है, उनको सारे संबंध ज्ञान वैष्णव तत्व से पता लग जाती है. फिर पता चल जाने पर क्या होती है, उसका जो मन चंचल है ना और इधर उधर नहीं भटकती, फिर वो इधर उधर नहीं जाती है. फिर उसको पता चलता भैया कृष्ण ही हमारा प्रियतम है, अभी उनकी सेवा करनी है, उनकी भक्ति करनी, उनकी भजन करना. जैसे हमारे भारत में इसको पूजा उसको पूजा सारी दुनिया में पूजा करती है, लेकिन जब वैष्णव का संग हो जाता है भक्ति की है तो उसको पता चल जाता है भैया मेरे को गिरधर गोपाल दूसरा लोग होते हैं. इसलिए गोपियां कहती है एक मन सो गए श्याम संग को आराधीस उद्धव मन ना भयो दस विस्मन एकदम कंट्रोल हो जाती है. इसलिए एक वैष्णव बड़ा ही सुंदर उदाहरण दे रहे थे.
So Vaishnava is describing very beautifully, he is describing the meaning of Virya. Virya, literally translation, it means semen. It means semen, so why it is compared to semen, that it is my semen, this Harikatha I understand to be my semen. He is saying, Vaishnava is describing, that a young girl's mind is restless. How long is it restless? Till she doesn't have a baby in the womb. When she has a baby in the womb, and then after that she gives birth to this child, then what is her focus now? All our attention is how to bring up this child, how to take care of this child, and how to do anything that is beneficial for the child, how to protect the child from anything calamitous situation or a disturbing situation. Now this is the focus of the child. Now this woman's, this girl's mind is not restless anymore. Similarly, this Harikatha. Harikatha is like this, that you will see in India there are people, they are absorbed in maybe sometimes worshipping this demigod, sometimes worshipping that demigod, and they will keep on going this demigod, that demigod, and their minds are totally restless. But when they come in association of a Vaishnava, then what happens? Then the Vaishnava speaks Harikatha, and then they understand everything. Who is Guru? Who is Vaishnava? Who is Krishna? Who is Mahaprabhu? They understand everything. And what is my relationship with them? What is prem? He understands everything, and then his mind becomes controlled, and now no longer he is wanting to worship different demigods every time. He is describing that also. There is an example that
there is one painted, our Mira. She is telling me that the Girdhar Gopala is
not. Yeah, the gopis are saying, Uddhava is saying that.